George R. R. Martin is now 70? Did you know that fact struck me with an unhealthy amount of fear? George, author of a series we love so much and the man that made Game of Thrones possible, is loved by some and hated by others. And by hated, I mean there are actually people out there that feel they are owed the last two books in the A Song of Ice and Fire series and think giving death threats to an elderly man is perfectly acceptable and justified. And if you say, hey, maybe don't give death threats to an elderly man because you didn't get something you wanted, you're told you're a George apologist. Because telling people not to give death threats to an elderly man is now being a white knight, shill, and or George apologist in our society. It's a scary world, kids. Wear your helmets. With the show coming to an end and quite possibly spoiling some remaining storylines in the books, those that give him death threats and tell him to just die already if he can't finish the series. I'm not exaggerating. There are actually those type of comments on my videos all the time. Think that George isn't trying or working as hard as he should be. Or at all. Or there's the crazy people that think he's actually finished the books and just refuses to finish them. Or he's finishing the last two books at the same time. I like tinfoil, but that's even a little out there for me. However, despite the many people that claim he doesn't care about his series anymore, George hasn't hidden his displeasure and frustration with the fact he hasn't stayed ahead of the show with releasing the books. Because honestly, he thought he'd have plenty of time to finish the series before the show ended. Then he just got further and further behind. And further. And further. You may even remember his blog post where he wrote, "The Winds of Winter is not finished. Believe me, it gave me no pleasure to type those words. You're disappointed, and you're not alone. My editors and publishers are disappointed. HBO is disappointed. My agents and foreign publishers and translators are disappointed. But no one could be possibly more disappointed than me." And let's not forget that sad interview where George said, "I know there are a lot of people out there who are very angry with me that Winds of Winter isn't finished. And I'm mad about that myself. I wish I finished it 4 years ago. I wish it was finished now. But it's not. And I've had dark nights of the soul where I've pounded my head against the keyboard and said, God, will I ever finish this? The show is going further and further forward, and I'm falling further and further behind. What the hell is happening here? I've got to do this."
Oh my God, I can already see the comments saying, "I don't care about his crocodile tears anymore!"
But now that the show is actually ending very soon and he isn't done, George said he has mixed feelings on it. In a new interview with EW, George stated, "It's been an incredible ride, and almost all of it has been great. Obviously, I wished I'd finished these books sooner so the show hadn't gotten ahead of me. I never anticipated that."
Which is something we've heard George echo over and over again. He never thought the show would surpass him, but you know, George has never been good with deadlines. Ever. In his entire career. So I don't know why he didn't think on that before not realizing the show would one day pass him.
What some may not know is George realized he was falling behind years ago, though some call it too little too late, and he began to cut down on his responsibilities. In fact, one of the showrunners, DB, shared that while George used to write one script per season for the series, he stopped years ago. DB said, "After season 4, George made a conscious decision to devote himself to the books. Anybody who's read the books knows the task in and of itself requires about 64 hours a day to do properly, and the differences between the show and the books became difficult to track in parallel. It's almost like he was in a weird science fiction movie trying to keep two similar but different universes in his mind at the same time." Which honestly is an interesting angle to think about, because we know George has had trouble with his own Song of Ice and Fire universe and keeping certain plot lines and characters straight. He has actually relied on fans who have compiled all these sort of wiki pages to remind him, let's say this character has blue eyes and this character has yellow hair. So I could see where trying to remember the differences between the books and the show would also just mess with his mind. Now, if you're smarting because the show is ending and might spoil some or a lot of book details, George has been very open that the show's storyline has deviated wildly from his books, stating that there are characters alive in the show that are dead in the books, and characters dead in the show that will never die in the books. Not to mention there were a shit ton of storylines that were hacked out of the show. I mean, ask us book readers how many characters are in the books that have never showed up in the show. In fact, George touched on this before season 6 came out, writing, "So when you ask me, will the show spoil the books? All I can do is say yes and no, and mumble once again about the butterfly effect. Those pretty little butterflies have grown into mighty dragons." Some of the spoilers you may encounter may not be spoilers at all, because the show and the books have diverged, and will continue to do so. While that is true, there are actually certain things that have been spoiled for sure. For instance, the tragic reveal of Hodor's backstory is going to be the same in the books, as well as Jon's true biological parents, and came directly from George. But what's interesting about that is the showrunners have now decided to stop telling people what directly came from talks with George. Showrunner David stated to EW, "The concern used to be that the books would spoil the show for people, and luckily it did not for the most part. Now that the show is ahead of the books, it seems the show could ruin the books for people. So one thing we've talked to George about is that we're not going to tell people what the differences are, so when those books come out, people can experience them fresh."
And I can see why that's done. Do you remember after the episode where Hodor died and D&D confirmed that George had told them that was Hodor's fate? And people were pissed because now it was being absolutely confirmed that, yes, this is a book's plot that we spoiled in the show. So now they want to make it a little more, is this a spoiler? Is it not? I guess you'll see.
So D&D have now made it very clear they are not spilling any more of George's storyline through confirmation of what they were and weren't told. But it's also important to know that George is, as he says, a gardener. Take one of my favorite quotes about him and his writing style. "I think there are two types of writers, the architects and the gardeners. The architects plan everything ahead of time, like an architect building a house. They know how many rooms are going to be in the house, what kind of roof they're going to have, where the wires are going to run, what kind of plumbing there's going to be. They have the whole thing designed and blueprinted out before they even nail the first board up. The gardeners dig a hole, drop in a seed, and water it. They kind of know what seed it is. They know if they planted a fantasy seed or mystery seed or whatever. But as the plant comes up and they water it, they don't know how many branches it's going to have. They find out as it grows. And I'm much more of a gardener than an architect." So knowing that and knowing what type of writer George is, it makes sense that no matter how much information of his future books he gave to the showrunners, he's going to have plenty of new turns and twists that D&D will never know about. Even David said George discovers a lot of stuff while he's writing and they aren't sure of Martin's future storylines. But in a similar vein, George also doesn't know future or end storylines for the show. George shared, "I haven't read the final season scripts and haven't been able to visit the set because I've been working on Winds. I know some of the things, but there's a lot of minor character arcs they'll be coming up with on their own. And of course, they passed me several years ago. There may be important discrepancies."
Interestingly, George is currently so devoted to finishing The Winds of Winter, he refused to do reshoots for a cameo in the final season. So, crybabies of the internet, you could have seen George possibly get stabbed to death by a white, which could have been therapeutic for you, but we lost out on that. That's on you, buddy. That's on you.
So D&D actually invited George for a cameo in Northern Ireland for the final season, but unfortunately the stars didn't align. Reshoots made it so his footage couldn't be used, and George wasn't able to film again. He said on his cameo for the final season, "I was tempted to do the final season cameo, but I didn't think, just for the sake of a cameo, I could take the time to return to Belfast."
Shame.
Lastly, George wants fans to know he will be working on Winds and watching with fans to see the end of the show, but he wants those that love the books to know he's not done. He said, It's the end for a lot of people. It's not the end for me. I'm still deeply in it. I better live a long time because I have a lot of work left to do. So in essence, the newest EW interview with George and the showrunners let us know that George is sad the show is finishing before he finishes the books. D&D haven't spoiled everything because not even George knows a lot of what will happen in the books. And George is still excited about this series and he is still working on the books. Hey, like, subscribe, and remember, there's a difference between being upset about something and expressing your upset and giving death threats to an elderly man. One's okay, the other's really fucked up.